another episode of Third and Three with Coach Holmes. Coach, we stepped out in front early, took control of the ball game, was able to get some reserves into the game late. I know that's kind of what you're looking for in a first-round playoff game. Talk about what we did against Toombs County that allowed us to prevail.
Well, I thought we played well in all three phases. Offensively for us, it was a very balanced night. No one player really dominated the game. I thought our quarterback played well, but I think really at the end of the day, our offensive line had a tremendous night establishing the line of scrimmage and doing a good job there.
In the muck.
At the end of the night, we took care of the football pretty well. Just a consistent night offensively. Defensively, Khalil White really did a good job up in the defensive line. Steve Linton had, I think, three tackles for loss, created a lot of big plays for us.
Lots of pressures, too, I noticed. He was getting around that corner.
He was there. He kept pressure on him. We didn't get a lot of sacks, but we still had the pressure that we needed. Rodriguez Martin with a pick six again. That was huge. And then in the kicking game, Kendall Wade being able to take a punt to the house. Smooth right before halftime, made a play. So all in all, good solid victory. Weather conditions were not great, but as bad as it looks this week right now, it looks like Friday night the weather's going to cooperate.
Yeah, it looks like based on all the forecasts we have currently, it's going to be crisp and clear and just a gorgeous night for football, and you couldn't ask for better conditions considering the two teams that are going to be pairing up. It's a rematch of the second round of last year when we went down to Thomasville and played the Bulldogs. It seems like we're Bulldog heavy here these first couple weeks of the playoffs. But, Coach, talk about the difference between last year's Thomasville team and this year's Thomasville team and what you guys are having to do to be ready to get another win in Shamrock Bowl.
Well, everything looks the same on film. Now, they have some different personnel. They graduated what I thought was a tremendous quarterback. Told a lot of coaches that came through here recruiting how talented the young man was. But he ended up doing baseball. He's a pro prospect in baseball. But they replaced him with a ninth grade quarterback that has already, as a ninth grader, 14 years old. He's been offered by Florida State. He's been offered by Auburn. He's been offered by Georgia. He's been offered by South Carolina. And the list goes on and on. Tremendous athlete who can really, really, really throw the football. He's got weapons on the perimeter that do a good job with it and a solid offensive line. Defensively for them, they're still in the same scheme. They're still doing the same things. We anticipate it being very similar to what we faced last year. I think our big concerns is their depth. They dress about 90 kids.
Wow.
They go
North Florida football for you.
They two platoon. They go real fast on offense. They have a real fast tempo. Don't huddle up. And then in the kicking game, they've been solid. Now, their kicker is good, but I don't think he's really as good as the one they had last year who knocked down, I don't know, three or four 50-something-plus yard field goals. But weather conditions, being in the Shamrock Bowl, the grass is going to be a little wet. It's probably going to be a little soft. And hopefully that'll negate a little bit of their team speed.
Well, Coach, we hope that everybody will come out this week. Last week, obviously, the rain and the umbrellas were out, and people were huddling up under them, so we didn't have as big a crowd as we would have liked for our first round. We hope the second round is going to be packed out because this is a marquee matchup. Don't let Thomasville's record fool you. This is a quality football team, and there's a reason they're in the second round of the playoffs. We're hoping that we can kind of return the favor from last year because that's a long drive back in two, and that drive home was a lot longer than the drive there. So we're hoping that we can return the favor. Same thing as last week. Tickets are still $8, correct?
Nope.
Or are they gone up to 10?
Tickets have gone to 10. Now, Jason, I want to explain to our fans again about the reserve seat section. There seemed to be some questions the other night. If you have your reserve seat ticket that was used during the regular season, all you need is your normal ticket to get in the game. Show the two ladies working the reserve seat section your tickets. And if you've got four reserve seat tickets already, four people are going to be able to go in and sit in the reserve seat section. If you don't have your ticket, if you've lost your ticket, if you've thrown your ticket away, if you do not have a reserve seat ticket, you will pay the ladies working the reserve seat section $2 for each person who comes in.
Very cool. And we hope that you guys will come out and support these Irish. This is a special team. Want to see some more special things. And hopefully be playing the day after Turkey Day. That's the hope. So we want you guys to come out and support us. And before we go, Coach, give me three quick names. You kind of named them during some of the other talks that we had, but go ahead and name three guys off that we need to look out for that played well last week.
Well, offensively for us last week, I think Barrett Wadley, one of our offensive linemen, really had a special night. He did a good job, and so did our Landon Amerson, our right tackle. I told our kids, I thought Landon had his best game of the year. On the defensive side, Steve Linton and Khalil White, as we mentioned, both of them had exceptional games. And then in the kicking game, you got to go with Kendall Wade, who also made some great plays in the secondary for us, too. So those three had great nights.
Made one very proud mama, too. I saw her in the stands. She was so excited whenever she saw Kendall score that touchdown, as all of us were. Well, we hope that you guys will come out this week. Kickoff, like always, 7:30 right here at Shamrock Bowl. If you get here a little early, swing by. We'll have the 101.3 guys. They'll be getting ready with some pregame, normally about an hour before kickoff. Make sure to tell all these boys as you see them during the week how much you appreciate them. They're working hard in the rain. They are sweating and they're grinding. And hopefully we're going to have a victory in a third round playoff that we talk about next week on 3rd and 3 with Coach Roger Holmes.